You're probably not expecting to see a face from the future in this series, and I hadn't been planning to, but I felt this week's episode could use a little more background information, and I'm going to use the opportunity to introduce myself. My name is Frauke. I'm the granddaughter of Cora and Jenny, and daughter of Erika. Like my grandparents, I've had an American experience myself. In 2003, when I was 18 years old, I went to Wisconsin as an exchange student for one semester of high school. Of course, this was a different phase of life. It was a new century. I went by myself on an airplane. I was staying with a host family, and the internet was invented. However, many of the differences and similarities my grandparents noted in their letters are very familiar to me, even though our experiences were 45 years apart. I used emails to keep my family and friends back home up to date, but was also lucky enough to receive many wonderful postcards, mainly from my mother, grandmother, and great-aunt. I'd like to share a little more information about the episode, The Tournament of Roses Parade. From 1916 onwards, the Rose Parade was combined with the Rose Bowl game, which is an annual American college football bowl game held at the Rose Bowl Stadium in Pasadena. In 1960, the second and last time Cora, Jenny, and Erika saw the parade, the teams that played each other were the Wisconsin Badgers and the Washington Huskies. Before I started doing research for this episode, I didn't know this. It's such a coincidence that our stories come together this way, this easily, and I couldn't help but share a little bit about it in this behind-the-scenes video. Unfortunately, Wisconsin lost. For the previous episodes, I've used my grandparents' letters as my main source of information, accompanied mostly by their own photographs and film material. In the letters describing their experience of the Rose Parade, Cora quoted a newspaper article that had covered the event. He hadn't mentioned the title of the newspaper, so I did a little digging myself. Thanks to the wonderful World Wide Web, you can find digitalized newspapers from many centuries ago. I've used newspapers as a source before when I was writing my thesis for my art history degree at Utrecht University, and it is such a wonderful true source of the particular period it was written in. It felt like I was there too, getting to know all these little details of the happenings around the Tournament of Roses parades of 1959 and 1960. While I'm here talking to you, I would like to inform you that from this point on, the episodes will cover my grandparents' expat experience in a little less detail. As Cora and Jenny started to feel more at home in the United States, daily life slowly but surely became normal to them, and they felt they didn't always have very much to write home about, which doesn't mean they didn't, of course. I'll read you a little passage from a letter that Jenny wrote to her sister Cori on the 12th of January 1959. Nog nooit tevoren zijn jullie zo trouw op de hoogte gehouden van ons doen en laten als de laatste tijd het geval is. Daarvoor moet je eerst een heel eind van elkaar zitten. Als ik vanuit Utrecht één brief in de maand schreef, dan was dat veel. En dan was dat nog om een of andere dringende reden. Tot nu toe wist ik aardig wat te schrijven en had geen moeite om het blaadje vol te krijgen, maar zo langzamerhand begin ik uitgeput te raken. Cor gaat 's morgens naar zijn werk en dan blijven Erika en ik alleen achter en vermaken ons dan met elkaar. That is why I've decided to look at the photographs, letters, and film material I have of them and make episodes around those topics. I hope you will continue to enjoy this series, and if you do, it would mean a lot to me if you would take the time to subscribe to this channel. It's free, and this way you'll be notified of new episodes when they come out. It would also help a lot if you would give the videos a thumbs up and leave comments so we can interact with each other. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.